The city of Tulsa has diversified greatly over the years, but is still known worldwide for two distinct endeavors, oil and golf. They are inextricably bound together. Without his success in building up the Warren Petroleum Company, young W.K. Warren Sr. would never have had the gumption in 1934 to walk into the Chicago office of a fellow oilman, the legendary Waite Phillips, and ask him to donate a 300-acre section of prime rolling real estate in South Tulsa for a new country club in Tulsa. Phillips, who also famously gave away his 72-room mansion that later became the Phil Brook Museum of Art and the land for the Philmont Boy Scout Ranch in New Mexico, laughed at this proposition. He told Warren that if he wanted the land, he must earn it, go out in the heart of the Great Depression and find 150 fellow believers willing to part with $1,000 each to build the club. Then he would donate the land. Well, Phillips found the right man for the task. Using the now legendary Warren focus and dedication that he later passed on to his son, Warren quickly lined up 140 commitments. Phillips was impressed. Southern Hills Country Club was built, and it's been making history ever since. The same combination of grit and superb salesmanship were on display 55 years later, when Southern Hills was considering whether to expand on the original 18 holes designed by Ardmore banker Perry Maxwell. It was not a boom cycle for oil, and money was tight for many members, but Bill Warren Jr. persuaded just enough members for the vote to pass. Then, in his father's visionary style, hired Ben Crenshaw and Bill Coor to build the West Nine. The move helped kickstart the architectural careers of what is now the world's most sought-after design duo, while giving Southern Hills room to expand its golf programs and grow its membership. Those involved in Southern Hills golf programming today cannot imagine life without the West Nine.
You know, I believe kings talk to kings, and I think he could persuade people to do things and believe what he's saying just about as good as anybody.
Bill Warren Jr. also made vital contributions to Southern Hills' legacy by working behind the scenes with key USGA and PGA members to help land both the 1994 PGA Championship and the 2001 US Open.
So his whole thought process was to not just help Southern Hills, but to help the city, because the tax revenues off these events are enormous for the city. And if you love Oklahoma and love Tulsa, you want these things to happen.
The U.S. Open was a huge event. Brought people from all over the world. I can remember people coming from France, Italy, Ireland, Scotland, and because we were having the U.S. Open in Tulsa. And I think it sort of put Tulsa on the map as far as a lovely city to live in.
The Warrens, both pillars of the Tulsa community in so many respects, from oil and gas to the broad-reaching St. Francis Medical Complex, are the first Oklahoma Golf Hall of Fame inductees in a new contributors to the game category. They may not have spent their lives playing or teaching golf, but use their vision, resources, and determination to make an impact on a local, state, and national level.
There's a big difference between being a visionary and a daydreamer. Whatever the Warrens get involved with, it has to be first class. And when they get involved, they're all in.
There was this twinkle which indicated his love for the game or love for people. What he has done to help behind the scenes for this city to get things like the US Open or the PGA are remarkable.
Warren Jr. is also a huge supporter of his alma mater, Notre Dame, where he largely funded construction of the renowned Warren Golf Club, also designed by Crenshaw and Coor. He also was a founding donor for the construction of the renowned Karsten Creek Golf Club in Stillwater, where the second hole is named in his honor. John Kelly Warren, chairman of the board of directors at St. Francis Hospital, founded by Warren Sr., is Warren Jr.'s son and a world-class triathlete who has competed in the famed Ironman. He has witnessed the legendary Warren determination up close and inherited a good dose himself.
Well, it's awfully tough to follow in the footsteps of what my grandfather and father had set forth. I mean, they both love the game so much. And for my grandfather, it was about business. For my father, I think it's just been for the love of the game. You know, I think if there is a legacy, it's to champion Tulsa.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome W.K. Warren Sr. and W.K. Warren Jr. into the Oklahoma Golf Hall of Fame.